Hi, this is Ros Gold-Onwude, born and raised in Queens, New York City, and I headed out west to attend Stanford University, where I received both my bachelor's and master's degree, and I played for the women's basketball team. Since graduating, I've started a career in broadcasting, and these are a few clips from my second year.
Hi, everybody. Mike Crispino along with Ros Gold-Onwude. The Liberty and the Sparks this afternoon. This Sparks team presents some tough matchups, and not just because they have Candace Parker leading the way.
In addition to Candace Parker, this is a Sparks team that has top-tier talent up and down that roster, which is a big reason why they've already solidified their spot in the Western Conference playoffs and why they're such a high-scoring offense, actually number two in the league for points per game.
Here in Baton Rouge, both LSU and Penn State were trying to end a long Sweet 16 drought, and Penn State comes away with a 10-point victory over the Lady Tigers on the Lady Tigers' home floor. Bob Picozzi along with former Stanford guard Ros Gold-Onwude. And Ros, it's great if you're Penn State and you have two first-team all-Big Ten guards, and they really picked each other up and their team tonight.
It's a luxury that Coquise Washington has. Maggie Lucas started the game off red hot immediately from the three-point line, knocking it down against the zone. They found her through penetration and kicks. She was open, no one was there. And then off the dribble, creates it herself, causes the defender to fall down and steps back. That's her dad. He likes it, and Maggie Lucas is clearly feeling herself. Now, Bentley struggled in the first half. This is what she does well. She gets into the middle of the paint and causes the defense to make decisions. Right there, she made a good one pulling up. She gets the defensive rebound. No one commits to her on defense. She's able to take it coast to coast. Those are two guards that are going to be very hard for UConn to guard.
And it will be UConn. That is Penn State's opponent in the Sweet 16.
Early in the first half, Maggie Lucas was on fire. In the second half, she struggled a bit. How were you able to get her involved?
Well, I mean, she's a great player, and we did some things in transition. She got some open looks, but, you know, Nikki Green came up big down the stretch for us, and I think when we get a balanced attack, we're at our best.
But it often starts with your perimeter, and you said, as Alex Bentley goes, our team goes. And Maggie, how does Bentley make you a better player out there?
She just pushes the ball faster than anybody I've ever played with. She finds everyone, she gets everyone involved, and she still manages to put up points herself. It's amazing to play with her.
When you were coming to Penn State and making the decision as a high school student, you were taking a chance on a rebuilding program, and you're starting to realize all the things Coach Washington told you to imagine. Why did you take a chance on Coquise Washington?
Because I got faith in her. I really got faith in her, and I love her. I trusted her from the get-go, and she's probably one of the most sincere people I've met in basketball, and I just love playing for her.
Tina, you didn't even start playing basketball until around junior high school. Did you imagine then, as a teenager, that you would be the MVP of the WNBA?
No, that's what makes it all sweet. You know, I put my trust in the Lord. I go out, I just play hard, and I just work hard, and it's been recognized, so definitely gives you confidence.
What's your relationship with Coach Tebow? How has he helped you develop your game over the course of your 3 years in the league?
Just communication. You know, he tells me to go after it. You know, we work on things in the post. You know, he has me watch clips of myself, what to improve on, so he definitely helps.
Who's a vocal leader on the team? Who has a vocal style?
Jason Campbell.
We have a growling style. Thank you. Marcus Camby.
That little chihuahua, man. Get him out of here.
Camby just video bombed you. Let's go, New York. I want you to say it like you're mad.
Let's go, New York.
Like you just won the lottery.
Let's go, New York!
Okay. Hey, what's up?
Hey, hey. Let's go, New York!
You went literally dead last today in the media day shifts. Why?
I was in there working. I had to get some treatment. I had to lift. Just took my time. I don't know. I'm always last.
Best for last.
Best for last.
Where'd you go to school?
Stanford.
Did you play basketball there?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, I knew that. That's why I asked that question. See out there, viewers? You got to know what you're talking about, right?
Now, you were just in there with Tyson, and the two of you guys push each other on the court, right?
Yeah, absolutely. No doubt.
All right, but I saw that there was a lot of intensity in the green room on the rock, paper, scissors contest.
Yeah, I mean, I played all the time with my children, so I knew I was going to win.
In a romantic way.
Let's go, New York.
I think we should leave on that note.
Welcome to Tackle Talk. It's a new show by the 49ers for our female fans. I'm your host, Ros Gold-Onwude.
Hi, I'm here with David Akers. He's our kicker, a new addition to the team as of this summer, and a five-time All-Pro selection. But bigger than all of that, He's a guy with a big heart and believes in giving back. And in 2001, you started a charity called David Akers Kicks for Kids, and you teamed up with the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. What was the goal of that initiative?
Well, initially, when I started Kicks for Kids, I wanted the kids to pursue their dreams. Like, it was a dream of mine to play in the NFL.
You know, it sounds like it's a community effort, but also it's a family effort. And I know with your busy NFL schedule, I imagine that your wife plays a big role in taking care of three kids, managing illness in the family, and also a big move across country as you join the 49ers from Philadelphia. What is teamwork like between the two of you as you manage all of that?
Well, my wife's my rock. She's a Proverbs 31 wife, that's for sure. She takes care of the household. I try to take care of all the stuff on the outside. And that's we all have to know our jobs.
In the Arizona game, the player that got left a lot was Charmaine Barlow. So what that meant was when the ball came inside to Regina Rogers, Charmaine Barlow's defensive player would then leave her and then hurry up and double team Regina Rogers. The worst thing you can do if you're Charmaine Barlow, if you're the player being sagged off of and doubled off of, is stand still and watch, because that's exactly what the defense wants you to do. The best thing you can do is move without the ball. Burn this defender for turning her back on you and cut to the basket. Now, as a defensive unit, what you're hoping to see is that when this player leaves to double, that this weak side defender will then duck in and rotate down quickly and help the helper, discouraging any cutters into the basket. Unfortunately for Arizona, on many occasions, either this rotation didn't happen or it happened late. And Charmaine Barlow did an excellent job of moving without the ball, and Regina Rogers was an expert at reading the defense, showing patience, keeping her head up and the ball high, and then passing out of the double. I'm Ros Gold-Onwude, and I'm special reporting from the 2011 Women's NCAA Basketball Tournament. We decided to take things into our own hands and loosen it up a bit. We took a look at how some of the nation's best on-court strategists make decisions about their sideline attire. And because it's March, we thought it would be fun to see how they'd match up into their own bracketed tournament. I welcome you to the 2011 ESPN Coaches Fashion Brackets. Some of Baylor's biggest games also coincide with some of your most memorable looks. Whether you admit it or not, you are a fashion icon. So we wanted to get your take on some other coaches who get attention for what they wear.
And you're going to get me in trouble now.
You wore your pink leather jacket for Play for K. Coach Cole from Oklahoma wears this wonderful fuchsia dress.
I am envious that she can coach in a dress.
The dynamic duo from Notre Dame, Coach McGraw and her assistant coach, Neil Ivey.
Muffet likes a lot of I'm not a fashion person, so help me here.
This is a leopard pattern.
There you go, patterns, that's the word I'm using. Yeah, 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 she wears patterns well.
Patriots coach, Bill Belichick.
That is what I want to wear on the sideline. That describes me to a T. I would love to dress like that. He's got it going on.
So a hoodie and some jeans.
You got it.